they pretty much have a press blackout. You even said that the press that was allowed was very censored. You know, they allowed them in, but allowed no cameras to be accompanied. That's very strange. It's a very strange happening. So what response did you get when you guys arrived on the scene?
Well, when we got there, we drove around. They have a roving security guard within that little post area. And they're walking around watching. It looks like they had some kind of like a communications compound set up outside that gate with satellite and all that right beside those HEB trailers. So, yeah, they're definitely restricting media in this area. But other than that, what did you see? What did you notice?
Well, the one thing that really, it's really chilling is I read a news article that said it's costing American taxpayers $250 a day to house just the children.
Wow.
There's probably about, I would say about 1,500 to 2,000 children here. And these kids are out, you know, having fun playing soccer, playing basketball. I got footage of several of the staff members just driving around in their little golf carts, picking up soccer balls that fell over the fence. And so American taxpayers are paying thousands upon thousands of dollars to host illegal immigrants who are playing basketball, whereas we can't even take care of our own homeless vets.
Well, President Obama just gave them $2 billion for the year for this.
Yes.
I mean, it's ridiculous. I mean, we can't hire doctors at these Veterans Affairs centers. We can't pay to get this treatment done. We can't get people who need it, Americans, seen. We can't get them the health care they need. And yet these kids are just running around having a heyday, eating free food, staying at a barracks place, getting to play soccer. I mean, sounds like fun to me.
Well, the thing that we're really not addressing is why people want to come here in the first place. And one of the reasons I do believe is because of the violence in Mexico. But the situation that nobody ever wants to talk about is Operation Fast and Furious. We have all these guns going from the ATF down there to Mexico, which makes it a dangerous situation. So they say hopefully things will be better for them as far as safety here in the States. So we have a problem where we're sending the guns down there, but once the guns get down there, the people come here, and then they want to spend American tax dollars to house these people.
Yeah, but the truth is actually even more bizarre than that, because most of these immigrants are from Central America. They're from El Salvador, Guatemala, Ecuador.
So even just beyond the border, why are people coming from so far away?
Because all these immigrants, there's rumors in Central America that if you come to America, you will get amnesty. And even the newspapers in Central America are telling its citizens, if you go to the United States, you will probably get amnesty.
Yep.
And Obama administration has recently, through the Department of Homeland Security, put in a new policy for, they actually renewed a policy they initiated in 2012 called DACA, which is Delayed Action on Childhood Arrivals, meaning that illegal youth that come to this country, the Department of Homeland Security is giving them a two-year amnesty in which they will not deport these children. So that, and also ties back into when President Reagan signed in the Amnesty Act in 1986. One of the side effects of that act was that the family members of illegal immigrants that then gained amnesty, they moved to the United States too. So amnesty in 1986 exploded illegal immigration, and that's what we're seeing here now. Even though there's not amnesty by legislation, but by the fact that the Obama administration, through selective enforcement and through executive action, is basically making a de facto amnesty, that's enough to increase the illegal immigration by tens of thousands the past couple of weeks.
And not even just that, but you also have all the incentives where if you can make it to the state of Texas, you get in-state tuition, and other places you can get driver's licenses and so forth. But as we wind down our interview, I know you guys have to get back here and get your footage uploaded and so forth. But give me your final thoughts. You know, what stuck out most to you from your time there on the base?
Well, what bothers me is, to start off, I'm not against immigration. I'm very libertarian in the sense that I believe that people should be given a chance to make a better lives for themselves as individuals. What I do have a problem with, however, is the fact that our government is pushing the cost of this immigration onto taxpayers, and they are bankrupting the country. So the country is going to be worse for everybody, including the newly arrived immigrants. So this is a bad deal for everyone involved in the nation.
The biggest thing I don't like is the $2 billion we're spending on this. And we have Americans right now suffering, homeless, without food, without shelter. and we're dumping all this money here. We're not using the funds properly.
Exactly. And I second what you guys say. I have no problem with people coming here, but they have to come here legally because we have a system set up.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, we have a system set up where we have a Border Patrol, we have ICE, we have these other agencies that are there to enforce the border. But if you can sneak past them, or even the more modern times, if you can just go and surrender to them, then you get all these goodies and all these benefits. You can come here, but you have to do it the proper way. Staff Sergeant Joe Biggs, Kit Daniels, InfoWars.com. Thank you for your time, guys.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Well, you heard the guys say it. You know, there's not been much press coverage at that facility. They had the, you know, the staged media day where you could come in with no cameras and, I guess, you know, just write down what you saw. But these guys, they're out there. They're in the field. They're out there in the Texas heat, trying to bring you this hot story. The story is even hotter than the Texas heat, but that's what we have to do here in the Info War, and how you can support us, how we can send these guys out. You can go to Prison Planet. And welcome back. Telly Blackwood, an InfoWars.com contributor and a regular guest of our programming, was approached by feds. Federal agents came to his house, and they wanted to know about his affiliation with Alex Jones. Now, this is just another in a long list of chilling effects for ourselves and for our guests. They don't want people to grow in the liberty movement to become more prominent, so they come and they try to scare you with all these fear tactics. So let's see what Telly has to say in his own words.
Why do you think they wanted to come to you and ask you about Alex Jones and say you're being watched when you've just entered some of our contests? We've interviewed you four or five times, like your work. I think it's just to intimidate you and to get the message to me.
I think it was mainly a get the message to you kind of thing. I mean, I'm pretty sure they would know you guys, the first person.
I didn't know there was a tyranny and they diesel people to death in federal vehicles and that they torture kids and run snuff film operations. I didn't know they could kill me and my family. I'm so scared now. I didn't know they were evil, Telly.
Well, the funny thing is, other than the guy talking in the suit, he's the only one that said any words. Two big thugs that sat there and snarled. But yeah, I guess they're in the black fatigues, not armed. It's plain black, you know, fatigues, the boots, and, you know, short trimmed hair. Not only did they kind of have their hands on their hip or crossed behind their back, and just sort of snarled and tried to stare at me, not even blink the whole time. But I had a lot of military in the family and everything, so I'm not really that intimidated by someone just staring at me. You know what I mean? But just the fact, though, coming in and trying to, you know, at first I thought it was a joke, to be honest. I'm like, what is going on here? Okay, where's the camera? Where's someone?
Yeah, no, that's the problem, is them bugging their eyes out at you and radiating. They want to just rip your head off. I mean, they had this, the ATF came here one time, and there was this one really, like, big guy, but you could tell, he was like solid muscle, and he was just going, just looking at me, just, and I'm just like, you know, it's just like, God, the dishonor of these people. Dishonor. They're so weak. They think evil is powerful. They worship at that dark throne. Go ahead.
Yeah, I think so. I've been a wrestler for a lot of years. Seen a lot bigger, meaner people than those guys. So them snarling at me as kind of.
They all cry for their mama in the end.
Yeah, everybody does. And we all go the same way and we all bleed the same color and everything. So, I mean, I don't understand. I mean, I know it's an intimidation thing. I know they're trying to get a message to you or. Like I was telling Biggs on Facebook, I was saying, you know, it almost feels too perfect. It's almost like they want me to go and talk to you guys and get this on there. You know, what's the thought behind that? I'm trying to be paranoid.
No, they think we're all cowards. They think everybody will hear this and get scared. That's the whole thing. Better not listen to Alex Jones. Better not be involved. Why? They just lowered the borders completely. They're coming after our guns. If we don't expose it, then we lose everything. That's the thing. I'm not a hero. Telly, you're not either. We have to stand up against this. I mean, they're arresting Tea Party people. They're arresting Dinesh D'Souza. The IRS is going after Christian groups.
And look at Eric Holder putting his little Homeland Terrorist Task Force together, the FEMA camp, the NDAA. What do people think that's for? It's not for good television. I mean, what do you think is going to happen? What do you think this is happening for?
Hot off her win of getting Subway to remove yoga mat material from their breads, the food babe is back, this time with a petition targeting U.S. beer makers. She wants to find out what is in the U.S. beer supply, the contents of which may surprise you.
And there's no conspiracy about this. The only conspiracy that's happening actually is within the beer companies, how they've lobbied the Treasury Department and the government to keep this information secret from us so they can continue to make really, really big bucks. I'm talking billions of dollars by selling us cheap, harmful chemicals to us. And, you know, what's really important here when people start to think about these issues is that one signature, one voice can magnify thousands. And so I just beg everyone to go to foodbabe.com/beer and sign the petition, because if we get millions of people behind this, these companies have nowhere to hide anymore. Because if people know about this information, they stop to buy those brands, they start buying other brands, or maybe they stop drinking beer altogether, which I did as a result. You know, and this is what increases the health of the nation, the health of transparency in our food environment. And I think, you know, by doing these type of campaigns led by, you know, someone like myself, and I hope others have enough courage to do these type of campaigns on their own and their own blogs, I think we can really take over the world, because there's more people than there are that work at Monsanto and that work at these beer companies. And there's more people collectively that pay for their products that we can actually take back the ownership and start voting with our dollars and doing the right thing. And, you know, before the break, Alex, you asked me, you said, you know, what do you think has made your campaign so successful? And I just want to reiterate the fact that make your voice heard, tell the truth, and ask your friends and family to share it. Like, ask them. They said, you know, tell them, like, this information is so important. Will you share it with someone you know that drinks beer or know that eats GMO corn every day in the form of, like, Subway sandwiches or whatever? You know, someone that you know, and everybody knows someone, right? Everyone knows someone who's drinking Miller Lite or Bud Light. Like, everyone I know knows somebody, whether it's your college kid that's in college at a college party, or if it's your dad, or if it's, you know, your neighbor, or it's the person that brings the brew to the next barbecue. We all know someone drinking these brands. Shoot, just walk down the street and go into a bar and start telling people the truth about what's really in your beer.
And say, hey, bro, you know why, you know, beer gives you such a big belly? It's the high fructose corn syrup that's been in there for 30 years. You know, you ought to drink a local brew. And yeah. say, look, I'm not henpecking you. I care about you. Yeah, and people will be very thankful.
And, you know, I think
you can also say, hey, did you hear about the food bait? Man, she's smoking. You ought to check her out. And she discovered all this stuff that's in the beer. They want to keep it secret.
That's exactly right. You know, and well, the thing is a lot of people, I know the haters are going to come out, and what they're going to say is they're going to be like, oh, Food Babe wants to take away our beer. She's trying to make a mountain of a molehill, you know, and I'm not trying to do any of that.
Hey, if that's the case, show us what's in it. If that's the case, tell us, because, I mean, there should only be 4 or 5 ingredients in beer.
Well, you heard it right there. The food crisis is not coming. It's already here. Whether it's high-priced food, GMOs in the food, or simply unavailable food, you don't want to get caught in a position where you have nothing to eat. That's why you need to go to InfoWarsShop.com and pick up My Patriot Supply. You can get these for individuals. You can get them for families. Whatever you need is all right there at InfoWarsShop.com. Well, that's it for this edition of the InfoWars Nightly News. I'm your host, Jakari Jackson, and we'll see you again tomorrow night.